This one comes from Tina Nguet from Kempville, Ontario. And she says, do you think there's adequate transparency in politics? And if not, what do you think is being hidden? And why is it legal to withhold this information to the public?
Well, I thank Tina for her question. Increasingly, much of what goes on in government is less and less and less transparent. It's a very long list of what should be transparent. I mean, we've seen an increasing number of committee hearings held in camera, which means you don't know what they've discussed. There are never minutes published. You don't know what's said. Now, occasionally, in-camera meetings have taken place to plan committee business. But some of the committees have been meeting for months on end without any ability to know what's going on in there. I think that we should demand much more transparency about what goes on in the Prime Minister's office. We spend as taxpayers over $10 million a year for the Prime Minister's office. The budget of the Prime Minister's office has ballooned under Stephen Harper. And those people, most of them described as information officers, seem to be in charge of keeping information away from Canadians. Mm-hmm. And I think I asked a question on the order paper. I wanted to know how many people are employed in the Prime Minister's office and what are they doing? And as an MP, I think I should have been able to get that answer. And the response was to say, well, we can't provide the full number of people and we can't give you very many details, but sort of here's a list of the top 30. Well, we know that $10 million is being spent in that office. On what exactly? So there are a lot of areas of transparency. The Auditor General has shown a light on the F-35's issue. But there are a lot of government decisions where you go, where's the public policy? Where's the, for instance, another transparency issue is what's it going to cost that we just passed the Omnibus Crime Bill? The Parliamentary Budget Officer says it's going to cost billions in the building of new prisons. But Stephen Harper says no, but hasn't provided any information on what it will cost.
We can kind of point fingers, I guess, at the Conservatives, because they're in power right now. Yeah. They've got a majority government. But, I mean, is this just a problem with a democratic institution? That, it doesn't have to be Conservatives. It could be anybody that gets in and blocks this kind of information from you, I guess.
It could be, but nobody's been as secretive or as controlling as Stephen Harper. I go back to my first experience working in government, which was in the government of Brian Mulroney, so progressive conservative, and I wasn't a member of the party, but I was recruited to come work in the Minister of Environment's office. This kind of stuff would have, if what's been happening in Ottawa in the years since I've been elected were happening back then, would be front page headlines. People would say, the Prime Minister's office is trying to interfere in the funding to a charitable environmental group. This is a scandal. They never would have tried. It never would have happened. And now it's just so routine, it kind of rolls off people's backs. So yes, it's true, and I wrote about this in my book, that the growth of the existence of the Prime Minister's office started under Pierre Trudeau. It has steadily grown in terms of its size and its ability to try to control media coverage of the government. But, you know, if you sort of a steady trend line from Pierre Trudeau through the Mulroney years to Chrétien, Martin leveled off a bit because Paul Martin talked about the democratic deficit, tried to redress it a bit. And then you get to Stephen Harper, it kind of goes off the charts for controlling every statement a minister makes. That never used to happen. I worked with the Minister of Environment very closely. None of his speeches ever went through PMO for pre-approval. These guys have to read from their answers from a script in question period, not because they don't know what to say, but because they're not allowed to say something that isn't pre-approved by the Prime Minister's office. This is a scandalous level of control. So I totally agree with the concerns that Tina's expressing, and I think as Canadians, we need to demand that we restore democracy, because you're right, whoever comes into office next, okay, suppose Stephen Harper's gone and the next Prime Minister, whoever it might be, walks in the door, you think they're going to say, gee, Tom Mulcair says, gee, I think I have too much power here. I must reduce the amount of power I have. Or Bob Rae or his successor, or me. Well, me, I would cancel all that power. A different case. But I mean, it's structural and institutional, and Canadians have to demand that we have more accountability and transparency.